The Philippines' top cop accused of intervening in a case of his former subordinates tagged as rogue policemen who resell confiscated narcotics. In today's Senate inquiry, former Criminal Investigation and Detection Group Chief, now Baguio City Mayor Benjamin Magalong, told Senators Albayalde intervened in a case of the cops involved in a drug operation in Pampanga 6 years ago. That investigation showed the police officer seized some 200 kilos of crystal meth, but only declared 38 kilos. Magalong said the drugs the policemen supposedly kept for themselves were worth around 648 million pesos, or nearly $12.5 million.
General Magalong, you were called by the President to Malacanang, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Who was with you at the time?
It's not Malacanang, Mr. Chair.
Where?
We were called sa Manila Hotel, Mr. Chair.
Manila Hotel. Who was with you at the time?
We were with Aaron Aquino and Senator Bongo and the President, Mr. Chair.
And what was discussed there?
Mr. Chair, with your indulgence, I believe I need to seek the clearance from the President to discuss whatever was discussed during that meeting.
Well, this is a matter of public interest, and that's why we gave the data to the President. Your statement to the President, and I suppose he asked you about that, right?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And when he asked you, did he ask you, ano involvement?
I narrated to him what transpired during that incident, that anti-drug operation in November 2013. And at the same time, nagbanggit din po si Juan, si Aaron, si Director General Aaron Aquino. Tinawagan siya ni General Albayalde at sinabi sa kanya na huwag implement yung order.
Huwag implement yung order.
At sinabi niya na bakit hindi ko implement? Eh kasi mga tao ko yan eh. So ang ginawa ni DG Aquino is tinapon niya sila sa Mindanao para meron siyang action na ginawa.
Most of the time,
Albayalde admitted asking for updates on the case but denied he was trying to protect his former subordinates. He fired back at Magalong, who also claimed the police chief, like his subordinates, had purchased a brand new SUV back in 2013.
I challenged Mayor Magalong during the 2014. Now he's saying that earlier he was so emphatic that this case is so widespread and all the drugs flourishing in Pampanga. How come when he was the DIDM, he did not follow up the cases of these people when they were supposed to be dismissed in 2014 and 2015 when he had all the time? And with regards to doon po sa sinasabi niya, like what you're saying.
He might ask the same question about you. You're the provincial director. Why did you not do this to your people?
I was relieved, Your Honor. I really don't know what personal gripes that Major Magalong here has on me, Your Honor. Because this happened 2013. What I have in 2013 was a pickup truck, model, I don't know, an old model one. And I can even say that I bought that from a neighbor, Your Honor. Hindi ko po alam, Your Honor, why this is being, again, lumalabas after 6 years. I really do not know the motive of Mayor Magalong. And again, sabi ko nga, if he has anything against these people, it could have been done, or even against me, it could have been done way back 2014, 2015, not during my time as a chief PNP, Your Honor.
Di pa sinabi dito yung naka-blanket yung pera.
Albayalde, who was Pampanga's top cop at the time, was relieved over the controversial operation finally, for command responsibility. Galong says the 13 police officers involved were merely demoted despite an airtight case filed by the CIDG. Manila's Justice Department is now reviewing the case. Secretary Minardo Guevara says the results may be out by the end of the month. Let's talk now to Senator Richard Gordon, the chairman of the Blue Ribbon Committee, for more on today's Senate inquiry on rogue policemen. Mr. Senator, good afternoon. Senator Gordon?
Gordon? Yes.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon. Now, we have two accusations against General Albayalde that he called Aaron Aquino to ask about the status of his men, which you called inappropriate, and that he supposedly asked Aquino to not to dismiss the Pampanga policeman, his former subordinate. So how big a blow is this to the credibility of General Albayalde as a PNP chief, you think?
Well, to most people, that would affect his credibility because, as a as an officer, you should let justice take its course without trying to influence that whatsoever, even if he did not try to ask them to really do something in a very, very big way. Nonetheless, the impression is he was trying to, he may be trying to intervene in behalf of his people.
Now, we have Mayor Magalong saying that at the very least, General Albayalde had knowledge of what his men did, but do you think that General Albayalde was indeed involved in the illegal operation of his subordinates, or is there any evidence or any testimony to that effect?
I don't have any evidence right now that he is actually involved, but he would be a poor general if he didn't know how lopsided, how sloppy his people were in this so-called raid when and they were lying left and right, and he wasn't able to correct their actuations. Mm-hmm.
And if not possibly directly involved, could he possibly be involved in a cover-up?
That's what it is. We don't have any evidence so far on that matter, except for the attempt to, or the call to General Aquino. Mm-hmm.
With this issue hanging over the head of General Albayalde, do you think he should take a leave or even resign, even if it's just a few months away before he leaves the police force?
Well, you know, because he has only about 2 months left, no?
Yeah.
Maybe even less. He's going to try to ride the tiger, so to speak, no? But if something happens, then he would be embarrassed. I mean, if I were him, I would probably consider resigning already. So that he might be able to get off some difficult moments later on. But that is his decision. I'm not going to influence him whatsoever.
Now, sir, how is this issue with the Ninja Cops and General Albayalde going to be tied up to the main issue of your hearings about the GCTA and the whole prison
well,
system?
Well, you know, the Ninja Cops came about because of General Magalong, who was testifying on what on the shenanigans in Bucor, and that there are allegations, and this is true, that the drug pushers, the drug rollers there were negotiating and supplying from the outside, and payment was being made from the outside, supply was being made from the outside the prison. So as chairman of the Blue Ribbon Committee, I have a wide latitude to what I call motu proprio investigate and pursue the investigation that we bump into because of Magalong's testimony.
Mm-hmm. Now, the Bucor will be taking the hot seat again this Thursday, October 3, when your hearings resume. What more?
We're still going to finish the investigation on the police. We're not through with that. The important thing is to try, and we're getting certain officers in the government to give us the paper trail on vehicles, even on, you know, if we can get witnesses. Because in one case, we saw that land was turned over to one of the people who were raided by General Magalong. And we're interpreting that as part of the hoodied up. You know, they cut somebody and they dispose of the drugs and they ask them to pay. That is raidado. No? But the evidence isn't quite, you know, there yet. So we would have to really add more to make sure that we can get further evidence.
Will there be new witnesses, sir, this Thursday?
I think so. I think we'll be having more witnesses. We're trying to, General Magalong is trying to get two more witnesses, and definitely on the Bucor, we will have them. I think on the cars, we may have witnesses from LTO and from other sources.
Okay, Senator Richard Gordon.
Because that's the one that's connected. The immigration department should really find out whether this, the whole thing, because it happened 4 or 5 years ago, rests on the fact that you can unravel the mystery of Mr. Lee.
Right. Johnson.
And also Johnson Lee and Ding Wen Kun. So if we can get some purchase there, we would be able to do so. As it was, you know, we were able to discover and find out the committee in terms of discovering that the cars are being sold 3 times in one day. Who's going to believe that they're not trying to hide something there?
Right.
On 2 occasions, they sold the car twice to different persons, and then 3 persons on another occasion on December 3.
Subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel, and for more ANC videos, just click the I button.
We'll be right back.